What's happening? Andy here. I am joined today by Reed Melnick. Reed is with PopSmart Document Solutions down in Dallas. How are you doing today, Reed?
Yeah, I'm doing unbelievable. I think every day you have to live unbelievably. So doing well. Thank you, sir.
Good to hear. Good to hear. Now, you guys are a big office equipment dealer down in the Southwest. I'm up here in Western New York. We're still very slowly opening up. I think you're a little bit further ahead of us. How's Dallas? How's your team, your family? How are you guys all are making out? And then how's Dallas doing with the reopening and where are things?
Mm-hmm. So thank you for asking, sir. I really appreciate that. So Dallas has, of course, had, its degree of covert, cases and stuff, but percentage of people passing from it hasn't been as bad. I think Dallas, as it opens, will do great. We've actually stayed open as an essential business during this time. And, we've worked pretty well every day. We've rotated out some of our admin group, but so I think we're doing well.
Good. Good to hear. We talked earlier in the week, and this is kind of why I wanted to get you on and just chat about opportunities going forward, keeping your team busy. I hear a lot from dealers that some dealers are struggling more than others, and other dealers are just killing it right now. I mean, there are pockets of opportunities out there. It's not all about print right now. You've got a lot of customers who have IT needs. What are you seeing out there, and what are you doing to keep your people busy?
So right now, I've been 40 years in this industry, and there's been several different things that have happened during that course in time. So the key for us is sell your way out of it, right? So even though I have 40 years, own different companies, owner of this company, I go out as a sales rep, which I think everyone in the company should, and go out and find opportunities. There's opportunities under different stones now, right? So when you turn over a stone, there's either a good opportunity there or not, but you have to turn over the stones. You can't just sit back and say, I'm not gonna call anyone because I'm afraid I'm gonna hurt their feelings. You just have to go out and make those things happen. So with that said, we've been keeping our team busy. As a matter of fact, we did a 10 machine install yesterday. During the first part of the week, we installed in San Antonio, we installed in Austin and Houston as well. We have a deal going on in Mexico as well. So everyone within the company, we work safely, but we also know that our business has to survive. And that's what we've been doing. We've been doing well during this time.
Well, it is survival, and to your point, there is a lot of it's a lot of apathy can be created with a situation like this, where I don't want to bother my customers, I don't want to get in their way. I mean, first, you always have that, especially a new salesperson, maybe a bit, reluctant to go bang on those doors, and especially now that there's a situation. But we talked about this. Now you get the luxury of knocking on that door, or more likely calling up the customer, rather than, are you looking for any office coming, it's, how are you doing? Can I help you? What's going on with your company? How are your people doing? Are they working from home? Are they secure? And, talk about that, the security opportunity for you guys. And has that been opening some new doors for you?
Yeah. So truly, as we talked about before, this company is an old school company. Okay. So we do print devices. We do multifunctions. We do all those types of things. I've included ink, which has been a great opportunity for many of the print shops to do low-cost menus for restaurants and things of that nature. So that's really what we do. We're not the security guy. We're not a copier company who decided to take on IT or phone systems. That's not what we do. And I think for us, and I know it goes against all the grains of every smart person in the industry, but we like keeping our core business the way that it is. We like the fact that we can control it. We know our margins. And during this time, we didn't take on all these high risk technologies that could have put us under, or all of these additional employees that other people needed. We, you know, and again, we went out and we did just like we've always done, is giving people great value, great service in the print industry.
So focusing on that a little bit more, what are you seeing right now? What are your customers asking for? Are they looking for extended terms? Are they looking for smaller devices? I believe you should have known this before, but I'm pretty sure you're Kyocera, which would mean you have a pretty substantial, significant, I should say, A4 line, which in these days, the shift that was going on before the pandemic, I think it may accelerate now, right? As people are looking to put smaller devices in homes, rather than the bigger A3 devices. Where are you seeing a shift right now, or are you? What kinds of things are your customers asking for?
Well, I think one of the things that that we see is that there's opportunities for certified pieces of equipment that people need. So it's also modifying the existing agreements that the customer has, because many of these customers maybe have an agreement that included 50,000 pages per month, and that agreement, and they don't know it, so they're paying the same payment, and those things need to be modified and changed and find a way or an interim solution through this year to have a better value. Yeah, some people, it's great that we're able to do a 90-day deferred type of program. But the key is to have them recognize that the way that they're doing things now is not the best way for their business. And we have the solutions, whether it's ink, toner, small, desktop, Kyocera printers, whatever it may be, we have the best solutions for them.
Well, you certainly have a nice variety. I did spend some time on your website, and why don't I share that out real quick if I can remember how to do it. So tell me, you mentioned the markets, you're in Dallas, you're in... where else are you? So
we're headquartered in Dallas, and we service Waco Temple. We have an office in Houston, and we also have an office in the Valley, as well as three offices in Mexico as well.
Oh, wow. So you're on both sides of the board. I did hear you mention that before. I didn't know that. Very cool.
Yeah, absolutely. So again, you know, when I sold my company to Kyocera, and we have a great relationship, is that they did not buy my Mexico operation. So since 2001, I've been in Mexico, taking care of all the large plants down there. And, you know, they produce tons and tons of prints. I mean, without a shadow of a doubt, one of the things that's happened is that during this time, Mexico got a lot of manufacturing that may have been in China before, and all that manufacture has gone to Mexico. So since we have all those print devices, our volume rose down in Mexico because of that reason.
That is, that's amazing. I was going to ask you, what's the difference, the climate like down there? Here you have to adhere to CDC regulations. How do you manage a team down there? I would imagine you have locations, facilities down there already, or are you sending people back and forth? How do you do it?
No. So since 2001, we've had a company down in Mexico. It's a Mexico company. Okay. And we have 15 employees down there. So it is totally different than our US companies. So we are really blessed to be here in the United States, and people should really know that, because down in Mexico, the healthcare isn't as good as it is here. The public health system down there is not that great. People have to try to get private health insurance or see private doctors in order to really get taken care of. And here our regulations are fairly consistent in the things that we do. Down in Mexico, it's hit or miss, right? Also, you know, it's very important, like down there right now in some of the cities, they have like odd and even days that employees can come to work, and you have to be an essential business. Otherwise, they'll either try to throw you in jail, they'll harass you or do something of that nature. So we're really blessed to be here in the US, and our employees down there, they're really happy, because within all the PopSmart or professional office product companies, we didn't lay off a single person. We have a commitment to our employees and we have a commitment to our customers that we're always going to do the best things that we can. And I think that's really important.
I couldn't agree more. It's you guys are an inspirational story, and it's nice to see a company who is standing only in, knee deep in toner and ink to show that you can still make a living and a good living doing it, even during the pandemic. So,
right.
One last shout out. Anyone you want to, any last message, anyone you want to say hi to or thank you to or anything along those lines?
Yeah, well, thank you, sir. And, you know, I can share with you the relationship we've had with Kyocera, the relationship I've had over the last 2 years with Rezo has been amazing. So I want to do a shout out to both of those manufacturers. Nick Maimon has always been one of the greatest leaders of the Kyocera organization on the financial side. And he's definitely been an inspiration to me. And I appreciate the relationships that I have.
Well, you are always a great interview, and I appreciate you taking the time to chat with me today. We'll check in with you in a little bit, a couple months maybe, and see, as things open, see how the opportunities keep growing, and keep doing what you're doing. Stay safe, and thanks for chatting with me today, Reed.
Okay, yeah, absolutely. Thank you, sir. I appreciate it, and I thank you for all the good work that you do for our industry.
Well, thank you very much. Take care, Reed.